In this video, we are going to learn various operators in Python. Also, one more data type, which is Boolean. Let's begin. First, let me show you what is Boolean. Boolean is nothing but true or false. But why do we need true or false? Or let's say, where do we use true or false? Let me show you an example. Whenever we add two numbers, we will get one number as an output. Whenever we multiply two numbers, again we will get one number as an output. But whenever we compare two numbers, let's say 4 lesser than 5. Just go for a guess. What we will get? We will get Boolean, which is either true or false. In this case, we got true because 4 is lesser than 5. That's why we got true. Let's say 4 greater than 5. We got false because 4 is not greater than 5. That's why we need Boolean. We need Boolean to compare two things. Alright, now let's move to operators. There are 5 different operators. First one is arithmetic operator. Second one is assignment operator. Third one is comparison operator. Fourth one is logical operator. And the final one is unary operator. In fact, already we have discussed about arithmetic operators, which is nothing but addition, subtraction, division, and multiplication operators. Anyway, let's do it once again. I'm creating a variable a equal to 5, b equal to 6. I can do addition a plus b. I can do subtraction a minus b. I can do multiplication a times b. I can do division a by b. Even that works. This is what arithmetic operators. Now let's move to assignment operator. In fact, we all know what is assignment operator, which is nothing but equal to symbol, right? For example, a equal to 5. Whenever we use equal to symbol, we are assigning some value to some variable. This is what assignment operator. Very easy, nothing special. But what else we can do with assignment operator? In fact, we can do two things with assignment operator. One is we can create multiple variables in single line. Let's see how to do that. Let's say a comma b comma c equal to 11 comma 12 comma 13. Let's see what is a. A is 11, b is 12, c is 13. This is how we create multiple variables in single line. And the second thing which we can do with assignment operator is, let's say I want to increase the value of a from 5 to 9. How can I do that? There are two ways to do that. The first way is, I can create one more variable a and I can assign 9 directly to it. This is one way. And the second way is, I can do it like this. A equal to a plus 4. It will give us 9. This is the second way. In programming, most of the time we will be using the second method. In fact, there is a shortcut to do the same thing. Let me show you the shortcut. The shortcut is a plus equal to 4. What I'm doing is, I'm adding the value 4 to the value of a. Here the value of a is 5. So I'm adding the value 4 to the value 5. Now we will get 9. So these are the two things which we can do with assignment operator. That's it. Now let's move to comparison operator, which is nothing but less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to. These are comparison operator. Let's see one by one. First, let's create two variables. A equal to 10, B equal to 20. Let's compare these two variables. Let's say A less than B. We got true because A is lesser than B. And A greater than B. We got false because A is not greater than B. Okay, that works. What about less than or equal to and greater than or equal to? It is very easy. We have to write like this. A less than equal to B. We got true. What about greater than or equal to? A greater than or equal to B. That's it. Okay, that works. Let's see equal to. I want to check whether a and b are same. Let's say a equal to 5, b equal to 5. I want to check whether both are same. So how to do that? A equal to b. we got true because a and b are same. We have to use two equal to symbol. If you use one, it will become assignment operator. Okay, don't forget. What about not equal to? We have to write like this: a exclamation mark equal to b. We got false because a and b are same. A equal to 5, b equal to 5. That is why we are getting false. Let's say a equal to 5, b equal to 10. Now let's do it. A not equal to b. We will get true because a equal to 5, b equal to 10. So this is what comparison operator. Now let's move to logical operator. There are three logical operator. First one is AND, second one is OR, and the final one is NOT. But why do we need logical operator? We need logical operator to check two different statements in one line. Let me give you an example. It will be clear for you. First, I'm creating a variable a equal to 10, b equal to 20. What I want to do is, I want to check whether a is lesser than 20 or not, and b is greater than 10 or not. I want to check these two statements in one line. So if I hit enter, we are getting error because if we want to check two statements in one line, we have to use logical operator. In this case, we are going to use AND operator. First, let's understand how AND operator works. If you have two statements and both the statements are true, it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. Let's see an example. A less than 20 and B greater than 10. In this case, both the statements are true. So we will get true. Okay. Now let's change the first statement. A less than 9 and B greater than 10. All right. In this case, first statement is false and the second statement is true. Let's see what we will get. We are getting false. This is how AND operator works. The second one is OR operator. Let's understand how OR operator works. If you have two statements and either one of the statement is true, then it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. Let's see an example. Let's say A less than 20 or B greater than 10. In this case, both the statements are true. So we will get true. Now let's change the first statement. A less than 9 or B greater than 10. In this case, first statement is false and the second statement is true. We have one true statement. So we will get true. Now let's change both the statements. A is lesser than 9 or B is greater than 30. In this case, both the statements are false. So we will get false. This is how OR operator works. Now let's move to NOT operator. Let's see how NOT operator works. I'm creating a variable a equal to 7 and I'm checking NOT a equal to 7. We will get false because a equal to 7. Let's say NOT a equal to 10. We will get true because a is not equal to 10. So this is how NOT operator works. All right, these are the operators in Python. In the next tutorial, we are going to learn flowchart. See you then.